طويلة لا يسلم عليه. I suppose about us, the people of Islam, the people of the Sunnah, the congregation, one of us may fall in dispute with one another, and it could be that we boycott the other for many, many, many years, not even sending salams upon or returning salams to one another.
ولذلك ينبغي علينا.
And because of this, it's incumbent upon us.
أن نتصالح وأن نتصافى.
That we unite between one another and we forgive one another.
وأن لا يكون في قلوبنا غلا لأهل الإيمان.
And that we do not have any ill feeling in our hearts towards the people of Iman.
هذه صفة من امتدحهم الله عز وجل من عباده.
This is the characteristic of those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised from his slaves.
فقال الله سبحانه وتعالى.
Allah جل وعلا says.
والذين جاءوا من بعدهم يقولون ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and those who come after them, they will say, O Allah, forgive us and those who came before us, nor place any hatred or enmity in our hearts for those who have iman and those who came before us.
ومن أعظم الأمور التي تقربك يا عبد الله إلى الله سبحانه.
And from the greatest acts of worship that brings you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
ألا تحمل في قلبك غلا على مسلم.
That you do not have any ill feelings towards another Muslim in your heart.
وكلكم يعلم تلك القصة.
All of you know that story.
حين كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بين أصحابه.
When the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم was amongst his companions.
فأخبرهم أنه سيخرج عليهم رجل من أهل الجنة.
And he informed his companions that a person from amongst the people of Jannah will enter upon them.
فخرج عليهم رجل تقطر لحيته ماء يعني توضأ.
And a man entered and his lihya, his beard was dripping with water due to his wudu.
فلحقه أحد أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And one of the companions of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم followed him.
وذكر له عذرا وسأله أن يبيت عنده سأله أن يستضيفه.
And he asked him, is it possible if I can stay with you for the night?
فنزل ضيفا عنده لثلاثة أيام.
And he stayed with him as a guest for 3 days.
يراقبه وينظر ما هذا العمل الذي عنده حتى أثنى عليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وذكر أنه من أهل الجنة.
He was looking and wondering, which action does this person do such that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said he's a person from the people of Jannah?
وإذا به لا يجد عنده كثير عمل.
And then he found that he doesn't do much.
لا يتميز على غيره من الصحابة بأعمال أخرى.
There's no distinguishing factor or characteristic about him in comparison to the other companions.
فقال له بعد ثلاث.
And he mentions him after 3 days.
يا فلان.
أو فلان.
والله لم يكن بيني وبين أبي ما ذكرت لك يعني من عذر.
Yeah, unfortunately, there wasn't, an excuse really that I said to you before.
إنما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عنك كذا وكذا قبل أن تخرج علينا.
It was just that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said about you this and that before you entered upon us.
فأردت أن أرى عملك وما تعمل.
So I wanted to see exactly what you do.
لكني لم أجد عندك كبير عمل يزيد على غيرك.
But I didn't find much, distinguishing kind of characteristic or action that distinguishes you from others than you.
فقال ليس هو إلا ما رأيته.
There's nothing except that which you see.
إلا أني أبيت لا أحمل في صدري غلا على مسلم.
Except that when I go to bed at night, I do not carry any ill feeling in my heart towards another Muslim.
قال فبهذا إذن.
And the Sahabi said, it's due to this.
ولذلك إياك أن تبيت وفي قلبك غل على مسلم.
And so be careful that you go to bed at night and you have any ill feeling in your heart towards another Muslim.
إذا وضعت رأسك على الوسادة وأنت تريد أن تنام.
When you place your head on the pillow when you want to go to sleep.
حاول أن تصفي قلبك عن كرهك وبغضائك لإخوانك المسلمين.
Try your best to purify your heart from holding any hatred or feelings towards another Muslim.
حتى لو أساء إليك أحد.
Even if he did something wrong to you.
اعفو عنه.
Forgive.
وسامحه.
Overlook him.
واعلم أنه إن أخطأ في حقك فأنت كم وكم تخطئ في جنب الله عز وجل.
I know that if he does anything in error towards you, then remember how much you err in the error of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how much do you sin and disobey Allah jalla wa ala.
فإذا كان صاحبك أخطأ في حقك مرة فأنت طول عمرك تعصي الله سبحانه وتعالى.
Know that if your brother does anything wrongly against you, then you have disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for most of your life.
ألا تحب أن يغفر الله لك؟
Do you not love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you?
لو فرضنا أن إنسانا قذف زوجتك أو قذف ابنتك بالزنا.
If you can imagine that someone wrongfully accused your wife
وماذا تفعل به؟
What would you do to this person?
انظروا إلى الصديق الأكبر أبي بكر رضي الله عنه.
That's the great Siddiq Abu Bakr رضي الله تعالى عنه. May Allah be pleased with him.
حين كانت قصة الإفك.
When the story that happened to Aisha رضي الله عنها being wrongfully accused of committing fornication.
واشترك في الإفك ثلاثة من صالح أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And three of the righteous companions of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم were involved in this.
والله إنهم لمن خيار الناس.
والله they were from the best of people.
وهم حسان رضي الله تعالى عنه وأرضاه.
And it is Hassan may Allah be pleased with him.
وحمنة بنت جحش رضي الله عنها.
حمنة the daughter of جحش may Allah be pleased with him.
ومصطح ابن بنت خالة أبي بكر.
And مصطح the niece of Abu Bakr رضي الله تعالى عنه.
فلما نزلت براءة أمنا عائشة رضي الله عنها.
And when Allah سبحانه وتعالى sent down that which absolved Aisha رضي الله عنها in the Quran.
أقام الحد على هؤلاء الثلاثة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم performed the punishment upon these three.
ثم بعد ذلك ما كان يقابلهم بوجه عبوس.
And then he would not greet them with a look in which there's some kind of displeasure in its face after that.
انتهى الأمر أقيم عليهم الحد انتهى الأمر غفر لهم ما وقعوا فيه من ذنب.
It was finished and life carried on and what happened between them was forgiven and everything carried on after that.
كان مصطح رجلا فقيرا.
مصطح was someone who was very poor.
وهو من أهل الجنة لأنه من أهل بدر.
And he was from the people of Jannah because he witnessed the battle of Badr.
لكنه وقع في هذا الأمر.
But yet he fell into this.
وكان قبل ذلك أبو بكر ينفق عليه لفقره.
And before this, Abu Bakr used to spend upon him and support him financially.
فلما قال عن عائشة ما قال.
But when he said about عائشة that which he said.
قال الصديق رضي الله عنه والله لا أنفق على مصطح أبدا.
الصديق أبو بكر رضي الله عنه said after this والله I will never spend upon مصطح after this.
فماذا قال الله عز وجل لأبي بكر؟
So what did Allah جل وعلا say to Abu Bakr?
قال ولا يأتل أولي الفضل منكم والسعة أن يؤتوا أولي القربى هذا قريبه أمه بنت خالة أبي بكر أولي القربى والمساكين والمهاجرين في سبيل الله وليعفوا وليصفحوا ألا تحبون أن يغفر الله لكم؟
الله جل وعلا said that let you forgive one another. Do you not love that Allah سبحانه وتعالى will forgive you?
فقال أبو بكر بلى والله إني لا أحب أن يغفر الله لي.
أبو بكر رضي الله عنه said yes والله I love that Allah may forgive me.
وقال والله لا أنفقن عليه ما حييته.
And he said والله I will spend upon him as long as he is alive.
وعاد عليه بالنفقة أكثر مما كان ينفق عليه سابقا.
And he used to spend upon this stuff that which he never used to spend before.
لو وقع أحدنا في مثل هذا الأمر أيعفو عمن أساء إليه؟
If one of us fell into a similar situation like this, are we going to forgive this person?
يصعب على النفس جدا أن يعفو عنه.
It's very very difficult for our soul, to our nafs to actually do this.
لكن الصديق قد عفى رضي الله عنه.
But yet Abu Bakr forgave.
ولا يعفو إلى الكبار.
And those great lofty people are the only ones who are capable.
لا يعفو دني النفس.
Someone who is lowly in character.
إنما يعفو كريم النفس.
Only someone who is honorable.
ولذلك كله يا عبد الله.
And so, O slave of Allah, be this person.
اعف عن كل من أساء إليك.
Be this person who forgives everyone who has wronged him.
وصل من قطعك.
And join the ties of those who has boycotted you.
وأحسن إلى من ظلمك.
And do good to those who oppressed you.
تنال رضا الله سبحانه وتعالى.
You gain the pleasure of Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
أسأل الله عز وجل أن يغفر لي ولكم.
We ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to forgive myself and you.
أسأل الله عز وجل أن يصلح أحوال المسلمين.
We ask Allah جل وعلا to rectify the affairs of the Muslims.
وأن يؤلف بين قلوبهم.
And to unite between their hearts.
وأن يصلح ذات بينهم.
And to rectify that which is.
وأن يهديهم سبل السلام.
And to guide them to that which is pleasing.
وأن يجنبنا وإياهم الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن.
And to keep us away from any trial and tribulation that was apparent and that which is hidden.
وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين والحمد لله رب العالمين. طويلة لا يسلموا عليه.
So what about us, the people of Islam, the people of the Sunnah, the congregation? One of us may fall and speak with one another, and it could be that we boycott the other for many, many, many years, not even sending salams upon or returning salams to one another.
ولذلك ينبغي علينا.
And because of this, it's incumbent upon us.
أن نتصالح وأن نتصافى.
That we unite between one another and we forgive one another.
وأن لا يكون في قلوبنا غلا لأهل الإيمان.
And that we do not have any ill feeling in our hearts towards the people of Iman.
هذه صفة من امتدحهم الله عز وجل من عباده.
This is the characteristic of those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised from his slaves.
فقال الله سبحانه وتعالى.
Allah جل وعلا says.
والذين جاءوا من بعدهم يقولون ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and those who come after them, they will say, oh Allah, forgive us and those who came before us, nor place any hatred or enmity in our hearts for those who have iman and those who came before us.
ومن أعظم الأمور التي تقربك يا عبد الله إلى الله سبحانه.
And from the greatest acts of worship that brings you closer to Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
ألا تحمل في قلبك غلا على مسلم.
That you do not have any ill feelings towards another Muslim in your heart.
وكلكم يعلم تلك القصة.
All of you know that story.
حين كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بين أصحابه.
When the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم was amongst his companions.
فأخبرهم أنه سيخرج عليهم رجل من أهل الجنة.
And he informed his companions that a person from amongst the people of Jannah will enter upon them.
فخرج عليهم رجل تقطر لحيته ماء يعني توضأ.
And a man entered and his lihya, his beard was dripping with water due to his wudu.
فلحقه أحد أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And one of the companions of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم followed him.
وذكر له عذرا وسأله أن يبيت عنده سأله أن يستضيفه.
And he asked him, is it possible if I can stay with you for the night?
فنزل ضيفا عنده لثلاثة أيام.
And he stayed with him as a guest for 3 days.
يراقبه وينظر ما هذا العمل الذي عنده حتى أثنى عليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وذكر أنه من أهل الجنة.
He was looking and monitoring which action does this person do such that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said he's a person from the people of Jannah.
وإذا به لا يجد عنده كثير عمل.
And then he found that he doesn't do much.
لا يتميز على غيره من الصحابة بأعمال أخرى.
There's no distinguishing factor or characteristic about him in comparison to the other companions.
فقال له بعد ثلاث.
And he mentions him after 3 days.
يا فلان.
أو فلان.
والله لم يكن بيني وبين أبي ما ذكرت لك يعني من عذر.
Yeah, unfortunately, there wasn't, an excuse really that I said to you before.
إنما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عنك كذا وكذا قبل أن تخرج علينا.
It was just that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said about you this and that before you entered upon us.
فأردت أن أرى عملك وما تعمل.
So I wanted to see exactly what you do.
لكني لم أجد عندك كبير عمل يزيد على غيرك.
But I didn't find much, distinguishing kind of characteristic or action that distinguishes you from others than you.
فقال ليس هو إلا ما رأيته.
It's nothing except that which you see.
إلا أني أبيت لا أحمل في صدري غلا على مسلم.
Except that when I go to bed at night, I do not carry any ill feeling in my heart towards another Muslim.
قال فبهذا إذن.
And the Sahabi said, due to this.
ولذلك إياك أن تبيت وفي قلبك غل على مسلم.
And so be careful that you go to bed at night if you have any ill feeling in your heart towards another Muslim.
إذا وضعت رأسك على الوسادة وأنت تريد أن تنام.
When you place your head on the pillow and you want to go to sleep.
حاول أن تصفي قلبك عن كرهك وبغضائك لإخوانك المسلمين.
Try your best to purify your heart from holding any hatred or feelings towards another Muslim.
حتى لو أساء إليك أحد.
Even if he did something wrong to you.
اعفو عنه.
Forgive him.
وسامحه.
Overlook him.
واعلم أنه إن أخطأ في حقك فأنت كم وكم تخطئ في جنب الله عز وجل.
I know that if he does anything in error towards you, then remember how much you earn the error of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how much do you sin and disobey Allah jalla wa ala.
فإذا كان صاحبك أخطأ في حقك مرة فأنت طول عمرك تعصي الله سبحانه وتعالى.
Know that if your brother does anything wrongly against you, then you have disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for most of your life.
ألا تحب أن يغفر الله لك؟
Do you not love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you?
لو فرضنا أن إنسانا قذف زوجتك أو قذف ابنتك بالزنا.
If you can imagine that someone wrongfully accused your wife.
ماذا تفعل به؟
What would you do to this person?
انظروا إلى الصديق الأكبر أبي بكر رضي الله عنه.
That's the great Siddiq Abu Bakr رضي الله تعالى عنه. May Allah be pleased with him.
حين كانت قصة الإفك.
When the story that happened with Aisha رضي الله عنها being wrongfully accused of committing fornication.
واشترك في الإفك ثلاثة من صالح أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And three of the righteous companions of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم were involved in this.
والله إنهم لمن خيار الناس.
والله they were from the best of people.
وهم حسان رضي الله تعالى عنه وأرضاه.
And it is Hassan may Allah be pleased with him.
وحمنة بنت جحش رضي الله عنها.
حمنة the daughter of جحش may Allah be pleased with her.
ومصطح ابن بنت خالة أبي بكر.
And مصطح the niece of Abu Bakr رضي الله تعالى عنه.
فلما نزلت براءة أمنا عائشة رضي الله عنها.
And when Allah سبحانه وتعالى sent down that which absolved Aisha رضي الله عنها in the Quran.
أقام الحد على هؤلاء الثلاثة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم performed the punishment upon these three.
ثم بعد ذلك ما كان يقابلهم بوجه عبوس.
And then he would not greet them with the, you know, a look in which there's some kind of displeasure in his face after that.
انتهى الأمر أقيم عليهم الحد انتهى الأمر غفر لهم ما وقعوا فيه من ذنب.
It was finished and life carried on and what happened between them was forgiven and everything carried on after that.
كان مصطح رجلا فقيرا.
مصطح was someone who was very poor.
وهو من أهل الجنة لأنه من أهل بدر.
And he was from the people of Jannah because he witnessed the best of Badr.
لكنه وقع في هذا الأمر.
But yet he fell into this.
وكان قبل ذلك أبو بكر ينفق عليه لفقره.
And before this, Abu Bakr used to spend upon him and support him financially.
فلما قال عن عائشة ما قال.
But when he said about Aisha that which he said.
قال الصديق رضي الله عنه والله لا أنفق على مصطح أبدا.
الصديق أبو بكر رضي الله عنه said after this والله I will never spend upon مصطح after this.
فماذا قال الله عز وجل لأبي بكر؟
So what did Allah جل وعلا say to Abu Bakr?
قال ولا يأتل أولو الفضل منكم والسعة أن يؤتوا أولي القربى هذا قريبه أمه بنت خالة أبي بكر أولي القربى والمساكين والمهاجرين في سبيل الله وليعفوا وليصفحوا ألا تحبون أن يغفر الله لكم؟
الله جل وعلا said that let you forgive one another. Do you not love that Allah سبحانه وتعالى will forgive you?
فقال أبو بكر بلى والله إني لا أحب أن يغفر الله لي.
أبو بكر رضي الله عنه said yes والله I love that Allah will forgive me.
وقال والله لا أنفقن عليه ما حييته.
And he said والله I will spend upon him as long as he is alive.
وعاد عليه بالنفقة أكثر مما كان ينفق عليه سابقا.
And he used to spend upon مصطح that which he never used to spend before.
لو وقع أحدنا في مثل هذا الأمر أيعفو عمن أساء إليه؟
If one of us fell into a similar situation like this, are we going to forgive this person?
يصعب على النفس جدا أن يعفو عنه.
It's very very difficult for our soul, to our nafs to actually do this.
لكن الصديق قد عفى رضي الله عنه.
But yet Abu Bakr forgave.
ولا يعفو إلا الكبار.
And those great lofty people are the only ones who are capable.
لا يعفو دني النفس.
Someone who is lowly in character.
إنما يعفو كريم النفس.
Only someone who is honorable.
ولذلك كله يا عبد الله.
And so, O slave of Allah, be this person.
اعفو عن كل من أساء إليك.
Be this person who forgives everyone who has wronged you.
وصل من قطعك.
And join the ties of those who has boycotted you.
وأحسن إلى من ظلمك.
And do good to those who oppressed you.
تنال رضا الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And you gain the pleasure of Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
أسأل الله عز وجل أن يغفر لي ولكم.
And ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to forgive myself and you.
أسأل الله عز وجل أن يصلح أحوال المسلمين.
We ask Allah جل وعلا to rectify the affairs of the Muslims.
وأن يؤلف بين قلوبهم.
And to unite between their hearts.
وأن يصلح ذات بينهم.
And to rectify that which is
pleasing. وأن يهديهم سبل السلام.
And to guide them to that which is pleasing.
وأن يجنبنا وإياهم الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن.
And to keep us away from any trial and tribulation that was apparent and that which is hidden.
وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين والحمد لله رب العالمين.